everyone. Today we are going to learn the principle of mathematical induction chapter. So in this chapter we are dealing with the three words, principle of mathematical induction, and this chapter is a very good chapter and interesting chapter. And first of all, we can see what do you mean by the induction, and what is mathematical induction, and what is principle of mathematical induction. So induction, so in terms of the physics term, so here you can say one charge body is induced to another neutral body. So that depends upon the one body to other body. So in this case, in the induction, suppose you can say in the layman term. So what do you mean by the induction? Here, suppose I can say one example. Rohit eats the food. Okay. And Ram also eats the food. Hari also eats the food. Okay. And Sita is also eats the food. Correct. So these are the four statements. Here, Rohit eats the food. So this is a generic statement. Or we can say that it's a specific statement. Specific case. And Rama eats the food. It's also a specific case. Particular individual. Hari also eats the food. This is also specific or individual. And Sita is also eats the food. So I can write all the four terms in a single term. Rohit, Ram, Hari and Sita eats the food. So you know all are the human being. Rohit is a human being, Ram is a human being, Hari and Sita. So we can write it, all the four person eats the food. So this means here it is a specific case. Here all the individual statement is a specific case. But when I am trying to convert in all the four statement into single statement, okay, this is a generic case. My point is, if it is true for in every statement in a specific case, it is true, then I am converting into the generic case, then it is also true. So that means my induction from this example, I am getting one thing here in the induction, I am converting the specific case to generic case. That means one thing, if it is true for a single statement, that the logic is applicable in the generic statement. So that is my induction. Okay, then come to the mathematical induction. So what do you mean by the mathematical induction? So it is nothing but in the mathematical induction, okay, this is related to your mathematical statement. Okay. Sorry. So here we are dealing with all the generic statement, but now we can relate it to mathematical statement. So that means the mathematical induction is linked with the mathematical statement. And this mathematical statement is related to the mathematical relationship. Okay. So a mathematical statement is given to you, then you can find the relationship and prove in the both the side, left hand side and right hand side. Just taken one example. Okay. Here. Okay. Let me write. Here, let's say 1 plus 2 plus 3 ... plus n is equal to n whole into n plus 1 by 2. So this is my mathematical statement. Okay. So here there is a mathematical relation is present. So all of you know in 10th class you have already covered, right? You know the arithmetic progression. So when you see this series, this is just like a series. Okay, this is this series based on the FP series. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, what is the common difference? First of all, this one is the first term. What is the common difference? 1. When we can calculate the summation of this series, n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So, n by 2, 2 plus n minus 1 into 1. So, we are getting n all into n plus 1 by 2. So, this is the mathematical relation. This is the mathematical relation. So, this is the what? This is the sum of all natural number, and we are getting n all into n plus 1 by 2 based on this formula. So, this part is already you have covered in the 10th class. And this thing is not related to the mathematical induction. I am just proving what is the relation, what is the mathematical relation, and how we can derive from the left hand side and right hand side using this principle of mathematical induction. So, this chapter based on what? Principle of mathematical induction. So, let here, okay, the series is 1 plus 2 plus 3 dot 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 n, that is what? The sum of all natural number, sum of all natural number, correct? So, let me prove. So, for every n value, so here I am writing for all n belongs to n. That means whenever you can take all n, that means you can take n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4, n is equal to 5, and so on, okay? Suppose that means for all n belongs to n. So, let I am taking for n is equal to 1. Okay, so this part is important. This part is important. For n is equal to 1, you can prove this is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. Correct? So, let me take the left hand side and right hand side. So, now the students are getting confused here in the left hand side. And right hand side is very easy. You can put n value 1 here. This is the right hand side. So, n value 1, 1 plus 1 by 2. So, here it is. You are getting 1. Right. Now, coming to the left hand side. So, what is the left hand side? The number of term is only 1. Number of term is only 1. So, we can take only 1 here. Only 1 term we can take it. That means, sum up to 1 term. 1 term. That means, here you can take only 1. Okay. So, you can get left hand side is equal to right hand side. Correct. So, it is true for, so you can write P of 1 is it true? It is true for both the left hand side and right hand side. Now, coming to, let's say for n is equal to 2. For n is equal to 2. So, now left hand side and right hand side. This is very important. So, this is the concept and fundamental. After that, I will come to the principle of mathematical induction. Okay. In the right hand side, here you can put 2. 2 plus 1 by 2. So, it is getting 3. So, now coming to the left hand side. Here, left hand side is sum up to 2 terms. Sum up to 2 terms. Because you are dealing with the 2, n value equal to 2. That means, you are taking the only 2 terms. 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2. Okay? You are getting 3. Here, students are getting confused. When you can consider n value is equal to 2, that means maximum the student taking n is equal to 2. That is wrong. So, you are taking 1 plus 2. You are taking sum of up to 2 terms in first to second term. First plus 2. Okay, you are getting 3. So, your left hand side is equal to right hand side. Right? So, now here P of 2 is also true. Correct? Correct? So, now, similarly, for n is equal to 3, you can take it. So, in the left hand side, what you can take? 1 plus 2 plus 3, matlab, sum up to the 3 terms. Sum up to 3 terms. 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is 6. In the right hand side, you can take it. Then put 3 plus 1 by 2, that you are getting 6. So, here also, left hand side is equal to right hand side. P of 3 is also true. So, similarly, for n is equal to 4, you can put, I am getting left hand side is equal to right hand side. So here my objective is, what? We are proving by putting n values you want, n value is equal to 2, n value is equal to 3, n value is equal to 4, and so on. So is it possible? Is it possible when I am putting all the value of n and putting in this series? Is it possible? No. Because we have infinite number. Because here it is given in the question for all n belongs to n. So that means we are putting all the values. So it is not possible. So in this case, we are deriving. In this case, we are deriving a technique that is called a principle of mathematical induction. Okay. So first of all, we read the what is induction, then come to the mathematical induction, then based on this, okay, based on this concept and what is the problem here, why cannot proceed with all the numbers to avoid that, or in an easier way, we can define a technique is called the principle of mathematical induction. Okay, so let's come to the principle of mathematical induction. Okay, so I have written the principle of mathematical induction here. So this is the definition. So principle of mathematical induction states, for a statement, so you can take any statement P of n involving the natural number such that P of 1 is a true, first condition. In the second condition, P of k is a true, that implies P of k plus 1 is a true. If these two conditions is true, then only P of n is true for all natural number n. Okay. So now coming to, so what it the principle of mathematical induction states. So basically, just now we can talk about for n is equal to 1, for n is equal to 2, for n is equal to 3, for n is equal to 4. So we are putting the value of n is equal to 1 and we are getting P of 1 is 2. Right. So similarly, by putting n value is equal to 2, we are getting P of 2 is also 2. So similarly, you can put it for this 3 also, we are getting this value is also true. Okay. So now my point is here. Just now, here I have already explained what is specific and what is generic. So this, for when I am putting n is equal to 1, this is for the specific case. Okay, this is a specific case in the induction definition, in the specific case. Okay, so here I am putting n is equal to 2, you are getting P of 2 is also, this is a specific case. And for each value of n, we are getting a specific case. So now my objective is what the principle of mathematical induction suggests. So if it is true for all specific case, then I am deriving whether this mathematical statement is true for generic case or not. So that is my objective. If it is true for specific case, then it should be true for my generic case. Right. Let me give another example. Okay. A plus B square is equal to what? You know, A square plus B square plus 2AB. So this is a generic statement, right? Whatever the value you can put for A value, whatever the value, A and B, it always satisfied. So this is the generic case. Okay. So here also, you are already proof for n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4, n is equal to 5. So similarly, you can derive a generic case. You are deriving a generic case. That in generic case, okay, that one is your second case. That is only a second case. So I am putting n value is equal to k. Okay, and you are taking n value is equal to k. If I prove this for n value is equal to P of k is true, then if P of k is true, then okay, I can say this can be proved for the generic case. So how we can prove for the P of k? So if P of k is true, that implies P of k plus 1 is true. That is my second point. So first of all, I can prove for P of 1 is true. Then I can say that P of k is true. That implies P of k plus 1 is true. So how? How? Okay? So we have already proved for n is equal to 1 is true. Then you can say that n is equal to 2 for true. Okay? If it is true for 3, then it is true for 4, right? If it is true for 5, then it is true for 6, okay? By manual you can prove it, okay? If it is, similarly, if it is true for k, then we can say that this statement is true for k plus 1. So this is called the induction. This is called the induction because the mathematical induction is based upon the mathematical induction is based upon the inductive method, or you can say that inductive hypothesis. Inductive hypothesis. That means here hypothesis is nothing but the assumption. Is nothing but the assumption. Okay. So that means when you can talk about this value. Okay, this for n value is equal to 1, then you can say it is true, then it can be true for n value equal to 2. If it is true for this, then you can say this is also true for 4. Similarly, in this manner, we can say that if it is true for k, then you can say that it is true for k plus 1. So this is the best of the assumption. That means if P of k is true, that implies P of k plus 1 is also true. By putting the value of P of k, that I can show you later on. But my objective is here, if P of k plus is true, then that implies P of k plus 1 is also true. So that is my assumption. That is called the inductive hypothesis. So this is the principle of mathematical induction. So we can prove this two only. P of 1 is true, you can prove it first. Then you can take the P of k is true, that implies P of k plus 1 is true. So if you can do this, then you can say that P of n is true for all natural number n. Right? So this is the definition of the principle of mathematical induction. So let's take one example, okay, how this can be proved. So let's take this example. Prove by the method of principle of mathematical induction, this is equal to this for all n belongs to n. That same example I have written here. So how I can write, this is the procedure. Let P of n be a given statement. So this is nothing but a given statement. This is a mathematical statement. So I can write it. So P of n be a given statement. So that is P of n is what? 1 plus 2 plus 3 ... n well into n plus 1 by 2. So this is the left hand side, this is the right hand side. So why I am writing the P of n? So this is the principal statement. Why I am writing n? Because this is the variable of n. I am putting the value of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. Okay. So now here I can prove it. We shall have to prove for n is equal to 1. Okay. Then for n is equal to 1, so I am putting here P of 1. Here I am putting 1. So that is P of 1. So for P of 1, left hand side, I have already told you. Okay. So how many terms I can take it? For n is equal to 1, I can take it one term only. So what is the first term? Only 1. So I can write it left hand side. Here it is 1. Then I can write for the right hand side. I am putting here n value 1, 1 plus 1 by 2. So I am getting 1. So here left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So P of 1 is also So P of 1 is also 2. So similarly, no need to prove for all the numbers. If you can see here, by putting n value is equal to 2, in the left hand side you are getting 3, right hand side also you are getting 3. 2 plus 1 by 2, that is also 3. So no need to write all the numbers, this is enough, because we are already proved. If P of 1 is true, then obviously P of 2 is true, I have already explained. So now, the next point is, here we shall have to prove, okay, or assume. Next, our second point is P of k is true, that implies P of k plus 1 is true. So that in that case, you can assume, okay, assume, let P of n is true, or assume P of k is true. Assume that. Okay, P of k is true. You have to assume this is not true. This is very important. This is not true. This you have to assume P of k is true. That means for n is equal to k. So we can write P of k in case of n, in the value of n you can put k. Now we can write 1 plus 2 plus 3 dot 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 plus up to k. Why you are writing k? For n value is equal to k. Okay. So here k whole into k plus 1 by 2. So now I am getting the P of k value. 1 to k, summation of 1 to k is equal to k whole into k plus 1 by 2. So let it is assume P of k is true. So now we can prove it. We shall have to prove, okay, P of k plus 1 is true. We shall have to prove P of k plus 1 is true. That means for n is equal to k plus 1, for n is equal to k plus 1, that is P of k plus 1, that P of k plus 1 is equal to, I can write it. So what is the value of n? That is k plus 1. What is the value of n? That is k plus 1. So now we can put 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to how, what is the value of n? N is the k plus 1. So we can write up to k plus 1. In place of n, you can put the k plus 1. Okay. So here we can write in terms, in the right hand side, you can put k plus 1, k plus 2 divided by 2. K plus 1, k plus 2. Why it is k plus 2? In n you can put k plus 1. Here you can put k plus 1 plus 1. That is k plus 2 by 2. Okay. So here it is k plus 1. So what is by the previous term? What is by the previous term? So I can reframe this statement. 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to k. This is my previous term. Okay. Is equal to k plus 1. Well into k plus 2 by 2. Okay. So here I have just reframed this statement. Okay. 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to k, and then one extra term is k plus 1. Okay. And it is value is k plus 1 well into k plus 2 by 2. So now we can prove it, the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So this is the important. So always you have to remember, when you are proving the P of k plus 1 is true, always use the value of the P of k. Always the value of the P of k. That is called the induction. We are assuming the P of k is true, then only you can prove it the P of k plus 1 is true. So that is the induction. So here we are proving, okay, here we are proving P of k plus 1 is true. Here we are proving the P of k plus 1 is true. So now, what is my left hand side? Can write it 1 plus 2 plus 3 dot 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 k plus 1, right? So this value 1 to k, you know, so this value is the P of k value here. So now you can put the P of k value k of k whole into k plus 1 by 2 plus one extra term is k plus 1. Right? So now we take the LCM. K whole into k plus 1, 2 whole into k plus 1 by 2. So now we can take the k plus 1 is the common. Right? So we are getting k plus 2 by 2. So this is nothing but the right hand side. This is nothing but the right hand side. So here left hand side is equal to the right hand side. Okay? Okay? So how we can prove it here? By using the value of the P of K, we are getting the P of K plus 1. Right? So now we can say that if the left hand side is equal to the right hand side, so I can write it P of K plus 1 is it true? P of K plus 1 is it true? So if the P of K plus 1 is it true, then obviously I can say that P of K is it true. Right? Because you are assuming, we are assuming P of K is it true. If it is true for the higher value, then obviously you can say that P of K is it true. Right? So we have already proved the two things. One is P of 1 is it true, another is P of K is it true. That implies P of K plus 1 is it true. Right? So now at the end you can write it. Here we see that, okay, P of 1, as here we see that P of, bit 1, P of 1 is it true, first one, and second one, P of K is it true, that implies P of K plus 1 is it true. We have already proved it, okay. So now I can write it as per the principle of mathematical induction. Okay. So when you can see this two is it true, this two you have already proved it. Then we can write as per the principle of mathematical induction, P of n, that means this is my statement. So P of n is true for all n belongs to n, because I have already condition is here for all n belongs to n. So now we can write P of n 1 plus 2 plus 3 ... n is equal to n whole into n plus 1 by 2. It's proved. Okay. So in today's session, we have already covered the fundamental of principle of mathematical induction. Okay. And the procedures. And one example. In next session, we are going to cover few other examples. Okay. So requesting all of you, if you like my videos, please share, like and subscribe my Prayas YouTube channel. Thank you.